kitchen pantry scientist Liz Heinecke is here. You have two new experiments, and there's a lot of color involved today.
I do, and it's stuff you can do with things you have in your house. You could do these right now.
Awesome.
So this is just sugar, water, and food coloring. Half a cup of water. This has 2 tablespoons of sugar, 4 tablespoons, 6, 8. Ooh. And we're going to make a density gradient. So density is just mass over volume, like how many atoms you have over how much liquid you have in this case.
Okay.
So the one with 8 tablespoons has a lot more sugar, a lot more atoms in it than the one with 2 tablespoons,
going
right?
Going to sink down to the bottom?
It'll sink to the bottom.
So what
you
do
just
we put
take
in
glasses,
first?
You put in the densest one first, the one with 8 tablespoons of sugar. And if you're doing this with kids,
so you just pour it in?
Yeah, pour the bottom layer in, but then the upper layers, you don't have to do it right now, but you just gently like spoon. No, let me show you. Here you go. That's how you do it, Jason.
Spoon.
You like gently spoon it in so the layers don't mix, because the less dense layers will float on the other ones, but
it takes a little longer to.
You just have to do it gently or they'll mix up.
I'm all out of order here.
And you could potentially make some great adult drinks this way. I've never tried it, but aren't these pretty?
I've heard tell.
That you can do that.
What a great way to teach kids about density.
Yeah, party tricks. So here's another party trick.
Love it.
If you take a piece of kitchen twine and you try to pick up an ice cube, oh, doesn't
work. No.
All right, but I'm going to put a few ice cubes in these glasses of water.
Okay.
Now, you know we put salt on the roads to melt the ice?
Sure.
Salt loses, sorry, loses, that's a new word.
The melting temperature?
Salt lowers the melting temperature and freezing temperature of water. So if we put salt on some ice cubes and then put these strings on them, we're going to try this. So let's put the strings. These are wet strings. Put them across the top of some ice cubes. I don't know if this will work.
And then salt
then dump some salt on. It has to be like on the ice cube. There you go.
Was that aggressive? Is that too much?
It's not too much. Let's leave it. We'll see what happens.
Okay.
These are kind of small ice cubes. We're going to wait about a few seconds. While we do this, we're going to talk about the fact that this experiment would not work in space.
Why?
Because density gradients work because mass gets pulled down by gravity.
Oh.
And what are we lacking in space?
Gravity.
All right, so I don't know if we have quite enough time, but it's not going to work. We haven't had enough time.
But if you do this at home,
this experiment's in my book. If you do this at home,
we're good.
All right, and these are also such tiny little ice cubes. Okay, yeah, let's make it work.
The CCO ice cubes are a little too small.
Well, these are actually, yeah.
These are actually from my house, but they
melted a little on the way, so.
And then,
Do this at home, it will work. The science of this is that the ice, because of the salt, the ice melts around the string, and then it refreezes around the string.
Oh, cool.
So you actually form ice around the string.
You can kind of see the little movement.
Yeah,
happening
so, oh, go
there.
Ahead, pick it up. Oh, it almost did. You see it started to lift up.
Maybe that
we haven't had quite long enough.
I'm still back on the adult drink possible.
I know.
Yeah, that's
these
the
are not alcoholic right now, Esme.
Just cool it out. Just get all the freeze.
Sugar water with
some coloring. But how cool would those be at a party, you know?
They're so neat looking. I think I put too much blue in mine. But you can still see the green.
Yeah, it's already doing it.
Anyway, this will work at home if you try it.
Very good.
This is awesome.
Liz, we love it. Thank you.
Thank you.
More Liz experiments at kitchenpantryscientist.com. Go to WCCO.com/links, and we will hook you up.